They give new meaning to the phrase dancing for dollars. Tucked away just under the shadow of the Penn Station awning on 7th Avenue, the Salvation Army's Christopher Heinzman and David Kelly are making the most of their cadet training hours. The dancing duo have turned Christmas bell ringing into a full-body donation drive.
We're cadets at the Salvation Army School for Officer Training, which means we're training to become pastors for the Salvation Army. And instead of being in classes during the month of December, we come out here.
We started ringing the bell, and then we wanted to like do something that's just going to catch people's attention more.
And people really enjoy the music. You know, they stop for a while, they clap along. You know, even if we don't get a donation, we almost always get a smile from people as they're coming by.
That's worth it.
This is great. It's very entertaining to watch these guys dance, and we know it's hard for them to stand out here when it's so cold. So it's welcoming to see them having a good time doing something good.
I work up the street, and usually the guys just play music, so I walk by. But this made me stop and donate this morning.
7 to 2. We're up at 5 o'clock or 4:30 every morning to get ready. And we're out here by 7, and we're here until 2.
And it may be for the fact that their dance is not interpretive, which makes the display so welcoming.
Usually I just see them with a guitar or the horn, and they were dancing this time, and I was like, hey, why not join in? I mean, I'll catch my breath eventually, and as far as it being cold, it wasn't cold at all. I was dancing around.
We've gotten large denominations, but we haven't had a Donald Trump. We haven't had like a Mariah Carey or anything, which would be awesome because we danced to a couple of her songs. Chris thinks we've seen Cuba Gooding Jr., but it wasn't Cuba Gooding Jr.
I swear, Cuba, if you were here and you're watching, come tell me. Because he doesn't believe
not
me.
Not Cuba Gooding Jr.
From Midtown Manhattan, for the New York Post, Kenson Noel.